the politics watch. This is Sir B. Now by now you'd have probably heard about the major operation that took place in Augustown, or well, to be specific, an area known as Bedward Gardens. Some people call it River. Right. The story itself is all over the Jamaican media, so you'd have probably seen all that already. But what I'm going to do today is I'm going to talk about some of the weapons that were found and the actual individuals who security forces them take out, just to give you a better idea, right, of who these men were. Now, I'm going to start off with the weapons. Many times I hear me say, when the youths, their mind, right, and them culture becomes so acidic that even when them get money, all them do is use the money to invest in a death and destruction. They want to run off place, they want to control ends, they want to take over turf, want to be done, etc. Sometimes you might think to yourself, here he goes again, using hyperbole, trying to get some views. But it's the next thing for me show you it. Because look at your screen right now. You're looking at over $1 million. And that's on the conservative side. You're looking at over $1 million. The boy them even a fire Intratech. You know, Intratech, where many favorite entertainers them love brag about. Something called Tech 9. You think no little ordinary Jamaican can afford some of them weapons? Yeah? And them prices from the black market. Enough Jamaican do so-called good job, not have the disposable income to buy some of them weapons. Yeah? You notice the whole heap of 12 gauge around them? That means they're not even find the shotty. So either it's still in the bush somewhere, or the man will have it get away. But this is not even the complete collection of the man them have up there. Over $1 million. You look upon a car. You look upon the down payment for a decent house in a decent scheme. And you have 87 of them locked off in a bush. Till all them rusty up. Because notice I saw 87 weapons always looking up, because they're usually exposed to the elements and to them which place them, which where them lock them, make them susceptible to getting rusty. But don't make the exterior appearance fool you. Them a work perfectly fine. And them take life same way. Now, based on where the operation took place, it is remarkable that they were able to catch so much of them. Because them place it on a place where you can just walk through and then look a casual patrol. Right. Very bushy region. Right, 87 them know at the back of them on. Security forces who are not familiar with the area. Right. Unlikely for us run through bush, right, and just know them ago. If you don't know where do you get lost. So the fact say them could even get so close to some of them and them to the point it even look like some of them lie down well comfortable. See, if it wasn't for the fact that the picture of them so grimy on a YouTube with them on, they're sure they're not talking about. But in the pictures, you can see so the man them have mattress in the bush. That's a typical wanted man style. Because when things get hot, obviously them can't stay at them yard. See, this is the real life of an 87, you know. When things get hot, this is how you feel 87 living, you know, in a bush with expensive smartphone, expensive shoes on your foot, expensive weapon on your hand, and I feel like I don't have a mattress in a bush. See, this is what you feel with anything I'll tell you. This is what I'm going to show you in the movie then. Right? It sounds glamorous, right? It sounds fun. Sound cool and exciting. That's the real 87 life. That's the type of life who make even Nevada Hodges say he was ready for us dead, because he couldn't manage it no more. So all of the young youths them, who think say, hey man, this lifestyle, it is them lifestyle, it sound fun. Someone like say, me live like a real life, 87 John Wick, right? Dress up in a suit and live in a nice house and then lick down 20 man and go back on a nice, that's not how it work. Right, you better get, make sure say, like, you feel courage, right? A marker drug up your skin when you're asleep in a bush. And as before, security forces then turn up, come put out your misery. Now, if you want to see the picture of them, you can check them out on a page called Augustown 876. As the name suggests, this page specializes in Augustown, right? And the things that might happen in the community, right? In the area. So you can see all of the video them, all of the picture of them, right? Because the one thing to talk about it, we really have to see the picture of them to get a better idea. That's for the people who just want to see what went down. I'm also going to do a second video on Patreon. I'm going to actually show the grand picture of them and go into more details. The link is in the description. So, I'm going to check out some of the individuals them, who the security forces them take out, because people might have wonder who them man are. Most people would have never heard of them. Let me start off with the one named Speng. His real name is Colin Mignus Sr. He's actually the Don. Right? So they actually take out, right, a very senior member. Right? He's the leader. Now you might hear various names called, right? You might hear them referred to as Berry Gang. You might also hear some people say River Gang. You might hear some people say NDNC Gang, if you're wondering what that means. Means no dollars, no cents. Now, Speng recently lost his son. Yes, the son passed away from 87 and 87 violence, right, before him father. So in a short space of time, the son and the father gone. One at the hands of 87, one at the hands of security forces. Speng has been hot for a long, long time. He was a real nuisance to the community. Every time police close in upon him, him get away. He's actually much older than the others. The rest of them are young, young youths, but Speng is a bit older in her age. Long time, 87. Know the community, know the area. Know the little gap the men can slip through all the time, so he's been very elusive. But as the saying go, every 87 of them day. And him luck finally run out. The next person I want to talk about is an individual that I've actually covered on this channel before. Remember the video about the Chacha Boy thief? We are saying that none of these 87s have more money, have more things than even the people they made my tea from. Remember that video? After there was a robbery near Yui. Let me show you the picture, just for jogging memory. This youth, remember him? With the handbag in him, man? Well, he's among one of the five. His street name was Johnny. So this is a small world. Because obviously you know Yui, Augustown, the rider. So then just come down, rob who them want, rob, take what them take away. Matter of fact, I heard recently him even up garden side and rob people. So again, this youth was a major nuisance. Now I can't show you the picture. Because as I said, I don't know a YouTuber already, but when I do the video on Patreon, you're going to see the same hoodie where my way right now. I eat him dead, you know. Exact same one. So now that him gone, people them in and around you way, Augustown and them place, the Hope Road, they're going to be breathing a collective sigh of relief. Because him no ramp to pressure the people them. Only for you students, staff from even UE, right? People who just have to frequent that site for guard them yard or guard them work. Enough of them get something taken from them by the same youth where you see on your screen. And after the pictures and they come out, security forces them actually start look for him. Right. Then they know say, Lime was the main suspect, because as you can see, him face never covered. Right. And some camera angles, and they get a good look on him. Then they know saw him. But Bush Life, combined with the facts that you know them have them people who are look out for them and all them things, they say it was hard to catch him. But as I say again, every 87 of them day. So that was Johnny. The next one I'm going to talk about is a youth name, J Crime. That's him on your screen right now. Now this youth was a quote unquote artist, and you know what I mean by a quote unquote already. He was dabbling into music. You can find a few clips here and there of him, a DJ and really man. You know, I must say he was an aspiring artist. But after him put on the mic, a day, he could pick up the gun at night. Long time award. Start off as a little troublemaker until it snowball and get worse and worse. Until it get to the point where people could barely see him because him constantly fairly low. And at first, enough people never even know say him a bad. Because originally, them knew him as a schoolers, and I understand he was a promising student. So, at first, nobody never really know say mix up in the things until him name start called more and more. And then they realize, say, hold on, this youth is at 87. And this youth a mash serious works. You know the conveyor belt is highly efficient. Him end up on it. Well, now him come off. All the warning them used to get, BBC try and talk to him. Never work. But you know old time people say, who can hear will feel. See when this youth was making music, in him sang them, right? Cause I was seeing a few clips around the place. When I'm sang them, I'm a talk about NDNC and I'm a talk about August Town and Hulak, which gun. You see, if him did really boss, if this suit did take off and J Crime did become a household name in Jamaica, and then somebody did come out and say, you know, say J Crime is actually, as his name suggests, a criminal, you know that tell a guy already. You know, him fans them that tell already. See a bad man and why you won't make the youth them thrive, where you try hold down the youth them. I mean the youth name was J Crime. When you have a name like J Crime, how much goodness you think I go follow back on you? So now we have bigger crime. No J Crime. If he thinks a crime was a bad word, he would not attach it to himself. If him did think say crime was something we're gonna make nobody no want to link with him, he would not attach it to him name. If he thinks say attaching crime to him name are gonna make no woman no one go near him, he would not call himself that. It's because in Jamaica, crime, criminal, bad man, gunman, chatter, killer, those are not bad words. They actually have a cool stigma attached to them. To the point where youths name themselves after it. There's a reason why there's no J Raper Bull, you know. No youth can call themselves J Raper Bull, you know why? Because the culture no see Raper Bull in a positive light. Yet, who knows what might go on down the road, you never know. But crime, killer, shooter, quenga, killy, those terms are terms of endearment in Jamaica, so youth attach them to themselves. You can't show me a J Raper Bull, you can't show me a J Sprat. Right. You can't show me a J. Pitney. Molester, you can't. Because them terms, eh, not give you no ratings. But crime, killer, done, shatter, murder. Oh, them term there? Eh? Attach it to yourself. Worst if you can't back it up in a real life, then you're the man. That's culture. Now we move on to the next one. This youth named Tilo. Now we have to go check out a clip on Jamaica Observer's IG page. I think it's up on him IGTV. With this youth, Kerosene, gave a story as to how he made up lose stream life. I'm not even want to repeat it. When you get some time, go check it out for yourself if you haven't seen it yet. Well, I'm gonna check out that story about how him name Akeem, how Akeem lose him life. Make sure you bring some tissue and buy 2 unicorn from me before you check out that story. When you talk about the PR campaign, when you talk about the tears that does melt the heart of the nation, and next thing you know, Field 87 turn to this youth who is just an unfortunate victim of circumstances, and the decisions he made in life have nothing to do with what happened to him. You really have to see it to believe it. Now the final one is a youth named Dede. And I'm not even going to go to post film video. There's all like one clip of him. I'm like, sit down and I guess a barber line him up or something, and him Dede with film gun in his hand. So the whole of them youth are known 87s. All of them have a reputation. People in the community know what they're about. So August Town, even on many occasions you've seen PR agents telling you that they don't know why JCF and JDF keep about August Town when there's no reason for them to go there. All them do is go there figure pressure the people and for no reason. August Town has always been and remain a highly volatile era. When you talk about River, when you talk about Jungle 12, when you talk about Gola, heavily, heavily armed men. And because of the terrain, because of all the place set up, them have the advantage. So that's why when you constantly hear say JCF and JDF members get shot in August Town, because the place set up in a way where when security forces are patrol, 87s can easily launch an ambush and take out themselves. And this is just the start, because remember there was a story recently about a group of 87s go downtown, go take out a man who sell pillow, and then when they take out themself, police officer run out and end up wipe out one of the 87s them. Well, the man who lost his life, the pillow man, he's from a community called River, right? And 87 them will take him out, come from Jungle 12. And that in itself is going to trigger be a problem. So listen out for your August Town get hot. I don't know if this operation are going to maybe quiet them down, because you know when them big operation are going, enough time 87 just lay low for a while. But Jungle 12 and River, very tense right now. Them at it. Look how far them gone. Downtown. So you see a man drop downtown, you think to yourself, oh, I go to West Kingston man them. And then I go to a man them down a south side or down a Tel Aviv. All the way from August Town it I come from. You can't know what the source of some of these attacks. See, while me have to say, it is commendable that JCF and JDF even get close enough to them and have pulled this off. Security forces cannot rest on them laurels for too long. Because August Town is a place where 87 them specialize in a laying low, make the heat pass, and then come back out 10 times madder. Only remember one time, August Town, they go 1 whole year. And nobody know then. And people say, boy, August Town, turn a new page. Oh, August Town, turn a new page. I want to hear some of the 300 drive to get found. And the 387, gone to prison or dead. Oh, my name did I lay low. So the momentum have to be carried forward. This boost for the security forces get right now, it no means a time for ease back and celebrate. They need to go up on the front foot. They need to continuously go after the individuals them, right? Who are giving the people them, the law-abiding people them now, August Town, be a problem. Complete nuisance to the people them. People them all living at peace, like everybody else. So hopefully, we hear say, more operation go on. Right? And they must stop. Look for the money where them really want, because there's still many others in them. This is a small dent. And based on how 87 game set up, because this attack happened, and the man them were lying to, you know, Berry Gang or River Gang, whatever you want to call them. Feed them enemies, I rub them hand, and I say, yes, 5 of them gone. So make us see if there's any follow up after this operation. Well, the people in Jamaica, if you understand this, when the word come down, remember in the Precure Boy video, when we say when the word come down, and the call make, you would be surprised what the Jamaican security forces are capable of. When no for the little shackles them, when no for the bureaucracy get removed, and the security forces are allowed to operate, you'd be surprised what them can do. Notice how difficult this operation would have been, or even the Precure Boy operation, extremely difficult. You're going into bushy territory with the 87 of them, know the terrain better than them, and them could still pull it off. Now imagine your ordinary lane or your ordinary community where there's some house, and them know the 87 live right there, so, right, or there's another yard there. It would be far easier. More of the people have to realize that even though JCF and JDF have them issues, especially as it relates to things like corruption, from time to time you even make fun of them when you come out and say ridiculous things like tracking barrel is unrealistic. You have to also understand that there's some serious members in the security forces. There are competent members in the security forces who want to do work and who can do the work. But not for them money and woman, you might get free up. You might get the call. Bureaucracy keep North 87 alive. Bureaucracy keep North 87 out of prison. If certain people get to work or they want to work, we need to hear about stories like this on a weekly basis. Anyway, we believe this one right here, so because only a matter of time before the KAJ, which is the Kerosene Association of Jamaica, come tell me some must leave them 87 alone. He's been through so much. Why then couldn't bring him in? And next thing you know, tears start to run down them face, and the woke TVs them start crawl out of the woodwork to come comfort them. So as me say, if you want to see the picture of them and the video of them, and just keep up on Wagwan and August Town in general, check out the page August Town 876, right? That's where I got most of the picture of them and them thing they're from. Right, so big them up. And the next thing, I kind of like the idea of, you know, these different communities having pages where feature things are going on at the community them. I know West Kingston have filled them page from a long time, West Kingston Headline News. That's probably one of the first one them I can remember. Right, August Town have them page, Central Village have them page, That's a good look. Right. So check them out if you so wish. Again, I'm going to do a second video, which is going to be on Patreon. And that one I'm going to actually show the scene and go over the type of details I can show up on YouTube. So Patreon's got to go for that video in about half an hour time, as usual. PIA, you don't know, more life. Vulture Squad, go and do your thing. Bless.